You're in my face right now. Okay. Bitches, bros, and non-binary hoes, I am Tazzy and welcome to my channel. If you like fashion, anime, and DIY content, that is the kind of content that I make. So I recommend you stick around, maybe even subscribe. Today, we are gonna be reviewing two sweaters that I just got in the mail from the brand Steady Hands. So basically, I got these two sweaters for office wear because they're kind of just like anime patterns and not necessarily like, this is an anime character right on the front of your shirt. So I thought it would be sneaky anime office wear, and I have worn them both into my corporate office job, and no complaints so far. Basically, I ordered two sizes to check to see if their size guide was actually accurate, and I think that it is, so just follow the size guide on there because they are unisex sizes. They don't have female sizes except for their like line of female clothes, which isn't very extensive. So each one of these sweaters was $45 US. And then I paid shipping on top of that. I think altogether it cost just under $200 Canadian to get both of these items shipped to me. Neither of these items were on pre-order, so I was able to get them right away. I do have three more items on order right now that are pre-order, so I should be getting those in July. I'll make another video when I do get them. Steady Hands makes a lot of clothes and they're constantly doing pre-order releases, so if you want to buy something from them, you actually have to be pretty on top of what they are releasing and when the pre-orders are coming out, because they have some pretty high in demand items. For example, I bought both of these items maybe a month ago, and the Nezuko sweater is no longer available. I think the Sasuke Curse Mark sweater is still available, but only in one size, which is the small to medium, which is the size that I bought. The first one that I bought is the one that I am currently wearing. This is the Nezuko knit sweater. I bought it in the size large to extra large, and it is large on me. Next sweater that I got was the Sasuke Curse Mark sweater. I really, really love this. I am known to be quite the Sasuke hater, but I both equally love and hate Sasuke at the same time. It's a pretty complicated platonic relationship that we have. For some reason, as soon as I got it, in my head, I was like, you need to wear this with your plaid pants from work. And then I was like, what the fuck is wrong with you? But I really love it. In the video that you'll see here, I am wearing it with the plaid pants, and I really love the way that it pairs together. I think it's so fun and quirky, and I have worn that to the office and everybody loved it. I really love the quality of these sweaters. It's one of the best quality sweaters that I've ever purchased online without seeing. The knit is very, very soft, super duper stretchy, and then also it is completely woven in. The pattern is completely woven in. 10 out of 10. Like I said, after I received these, I already ordered three more items. I will continue to order items from them. Other things that I want from there, they have more Demon Slayer sweaters, and I do want the Tanjiro one. Unfortunately, the one for Tanjiro's master, if it's a really muted blue, it's very grandpa, and I can't decide if I want it. The Shinobu sweaters, I don't know how I feel about them. I just think that they're gonna look silly on me because they're white, and I'm going to stain them immediately. I also really want the Howl's Moving Castle cardigan. It's in the pattern of his coat with like the Harlequin pattern. It's so cute. And I expect that they're gonna be releasing a lot more stuff, which is so very, very exciting. I just absolutely adore this brand. It's ultimate tier merch for me. Being able to wear anime merch at the office is super duper cool. Thank you for watching this. I know this is a really short video, but I only had two items and I only had wonderful reviews of them to make. So if you liked this video, please like this video. I have no other way of knowing if you like my content than whether or not you're engaging with it. Like I said, if you like anime, DIY, and fashion content, this is the place to be. I am redoing my entire house. I'm calling it the Anime Home Makeover, just like Extreme Home Makeover, but for anime, because I am completely thematically designing my home to be anime themed. I'm very excited. I already started in the kitchen. I have a video out on that where I painted my countertops to be like a pink glitter magical girl wonderland place. So check that out if you're interested. Mm-hmm.
escape this time, but you've escaped for the last time.
See ya.